All right, we're back, and we're making the lid for the jar I just threw. Same thing, just gonna work the clay here. Down, up and down a couple extra times here because I didn't wedge it that good. And this also kind of not only like helps to wake up the clay, make it more workable, it also gets air bubbles. Good. I took this measurement on the inside of that jar that I threw where the lid's going to sit. And then I transferred it over to this by doing that. Which is that still good, or you gotta check and make sure it doesn't get bumped sometimes. Yeah, I'm good. I'm just gonna flatten this thing out. Estimate of how wide I want to make it. Alright. Make this jar a little skinnier than some of my other ones. But that's good because it'll be thicker. Take the thermal shock of the raccoon better. I got it as wide as I wanted it. Maybe even a little wider. Let's see if I can do that off, maybe. You always want to take your measurement for the inside of the jar right after you throw, right after you're done throwing the jar. Because if you take it the next day, the jar shrunk. And then when you make this, then this thing shrinks too, and your measurements are all off. But if you take them once both wet, they shrink, and it's the same clay body, they shrink at the same time. And end up fitting. Make sure I'm out perfect there.
Inside the pot, and you're not able to, like, it doesn't wobble off when you're moving the pot around.
Can you try to pick it up?
Yeah.
Turn it sideways?
Mm-hmm. I think that's important in a pot design or a jar.
Yeah, I guess that's a lot has to do with some lids go like this, and then a lot of their weight's more top heavy, and I think this one's kind of like has most of the weight down and just flat across. So that probably helps that, because I've made some, sometimes they're nice to have those dome shapes, because it continues if it's got out like a outer curve, nice, but yeah, that's kind of why I like this shape. It's it's a really functional shape. My wife Leah here is carving the pumpkin that I did in the last CodyO Show. She's out here hanging out in the studio with me. Looks like she's putting a beak on this one. Looks really cool. Still got a little much clay here. Then I think it's because I normally make them wider, so I take a little bit more clay, but I kind of need as much here, so. Got this about as thick as I want it to be here. I don't want to get it too thin. If you get this part of it too thin, especially without having that curve, then it wants to not sit exactly flat. It can kind of like, when it dries, the edges will come up. It'll kind of wobble it when it sits in there. So I gotta kind of watch for that. Make sure and leave it thick enough. And I'm just gonna grab it like this and make sure it feels easy to grab. That's kind of how I shape it. Shaped right to my fingers here. And I would grab it. Okay, it looks like I'm pretty much there. I just want to make sure one last time that I am exactly where I want to be with this lid. Sometimes you do pinching touches and it widens, or you don't realize it, but it widens or it takes in your lid. But in this case, it kind of widened a little bit, so I'm glad I checked. The clay I'm using here, and the jar that I made it with was 5 pounds of clay. I always use the same amount. Place for the wire to hook under, because I want it, when I wire this thing off of here, I gotta be extra careful with wire. Slow it down a little bit when I wire it, but I do like it spinning because it also helps me cut it off flat, and I'll wrap my finger around one side of the wire, by the other side too, and I can use my finger to help hold it down to the bat when I'm cutting it.